who are in charge of hiring know that they're out there, that you like their content, and that you're willing to support it with your dollar. If they have Patreons and you can give even a dollar, goes a long way to artists who give hours and hours of free time to try to create content that they're not just passionate about, but they know that there's an audience for. If you can do that, that is the first way to get people in the door. The second way to get people in the door is pushing creators to have not all white writer's rooms, and more importantly, not to have just a token in her white writer's room. A lot of times it's like, oh, look, we hired a black woman, so we're done, right? And I'm like, no, it's not. One black woman cannot represent all multiracial communities for you. It's just, or all genders or all sexualities. Like, you have to have diverse writer's room, especially if you're going to tell stories like, you know, we all grabbed Kindred Orange is the New Black because, you know, there are aspects of representations of us, but you can see in their writer's room. That's what I'm saying, though. It's all white, and that's why we have these weird conversations where they're like, black people can't be racist. And I'm like, oh, I just don't know what to do with it. I want to support you. You're hurting me.
Right, and you were saying about, you asked me if it was mainstream, and I think we have our own work to do within our own community. I also believe that mainstream media is, you know, researching us and looking at us and trying to figure us out. I don't know, this might be unpopular, but the L word, I feel like nobody represented me. And it took you three seasons to put in a black character, which is absolutely... I'm sorry?
Tasha, you're talking about like a fifth season?
No, she was
like, I'm sorry, I'm
fourth season? Fourth season? For sure.
So was my season, because Carmen, you know.
Hey. we have our own work to do. Well, my grandma, feminine women are white feminine women are represented in mainstream. Look at the L word.
Yeah, well, and even on the L word, I don't know, do you remember seeing an Asian? Because there was one, and she was butch, and I didn't feel like she represented me. She was like a background, she's an extra. Personally, in our personal lives, having these conversations with people outside of our communities and letting them know what that might be something you're interested in, something that you want, and kind of getting more people involved. I think that's the only way to see more Asian women on TV. I don't know the answer to that.
Do you feel like the Iron Fist, like to your activism of being like, we want to be an Iron Fist? Are you done this conversation with us?
First of all, no, I don't.
Okay.
Second of all, I don't know if it's also just Asians in general, like, and it's hard, and I can't speak for all Asians. In Toronto, we started the Pink Dot Teal March, which was raising visibility for queer Asians. But that's very local, right? And it's very micro. And when it comes to, I don't know if it's an Asian culture thing too sometimes, because even my own parents, I'm gonna get personal right now, even my own parents are like, why are you being an activist? Why does anyone else matter to you? You should focus on yourself and do well. And your career matters more than that. Why are you concerned about all Asians? You should really, you're not perfect right now. You should probably work on that first. So that's the kind of, like, you know, support system I think some of us come from. So it's also hard. Asians, I can't, like, again, I'm sorry for speaking on all Asians, I can't. But from my Asian family, they are very, you know, not necessarily enthusiastically supportive of getting out there, even when it came to, you know, I don't know if you guys are familiar with the history of Canada. Oh, yay. You know, the whole head tax paying thing, the railroad thing, even then, the Chinese are like, hey, we're really mad about that. We kind of always put our heads down and just kind of move forward. And I don't know if that's like a cultural thing. There are a few of us, I think, that are like, we don't like this. And we want to see a change, right? But getting like an entire, so this is where the race thing comes in. So the intersectionalities here, it can be really difficult to navigate. So I don't have an answer for you, sorry.
And sometimes, you know, money talks and bullshit. So you got, I think it's best to speak with the dollars. If you don't see, like, for example, okay, so March is like anti-Ghost in the Shell month. Designed this whole campaign that's like totally anti the movie because of the whitewashing and the changing of the story. And you know, I think people have been pretty vocal, like, I don't plan on supporting this movie because it's garbage. And like, look at the Great Wall, it's about to lose a whole ton of money, and we celebrated last night, it's still great. And it's not that I want to see people fail, but I don't want to see any more white folks, particularly, you know, I just don't want to see any more white folks representing Asian culture in any way. You know, in a world where, you know, actresses like Ringo Kikuchi and Mei Na Nguyen exist, I don't get
queer women I don't in
get the
media.
Idea that they felt they needed to cast Scarlett Johansson in something. Or, you know, where, you know, you have Emma Stone playing,
she's not Asian.
Allison Ning, like, I can't even look at her and believe that that's true. And
they do the same thing in the Martian.
I think we have to start withholding our money and putting it elsewhere and putting it in projects that matter. Because I think Crazy Rich Asians has been made.
Yes.
So I think you have to support things like that instead of, oh, Ghost in the Shell, the front wall.